Welcome to another episode of Back to Basics. I'm Shailaja Suresh, a senior solutions architect with Amazon Web Services. I have seen customers who have very stringent high uptime requirements for their transactional applications. And almost all these applications are configured using an active-active failover strategy. Does that sound familiar to you? If so, let's get back to basics. Now, before we look at a pattern, let's familiarize ourselves on a few concepts. Recovery time objective, or RTO, is the maximum acceptable delay between the interruption of service and restoration of service. This determines what is considered as an acceptable time window when a service is unavailable. Recovery point objective, or RPO, on the other hand, is the maximum acceptable amount of time since the last data recovery point. This determines what is considered as an acceptable data loss between the last recovery point and the interruption of service. And now, what is an active-active failover strategy? A multi-site active-active failover strategy gives you the lowest possible RTO and RPO. Simply put, this design has two systems in an active state serving traffic at any point of time, such that even if one of them goes down, the other takes over. Now let's look at how Aurora Multimaster provides near real-time RPO and RTO. An Aurora cluster consists of a set of database compute nodes and a shared storage volume. In this example, the storage volume consists of 6 storage nodes placed across 3 availability zones for high availability and durability. Every database node in the Multimaster cluster is a writer node that can run, read, and write statements. The Multimaster cluster doesn't need the failover mechanism because it doesn't need to promote another DB instance to have the read or write capability. Multimaster cluster nodes are connected using low latency, low lag Aurora replication. Now let's say an application has connections to 2 writers for writing. Let's say one of them goes down due to a disruption in an availability zone. Now the application simply moves its connection to writer 2 until writer 1 comes up, thereby making it a near real-time experience to maintain application uptime with the database operations. At AWS, we prescribe well-architected architecture patterns to our customers. That said, an Aurora Multimaster cluster architecture pattern comes to you handy for applications that require segmented workloads, like multi-tenant applications, which require an active-active failover strategy. Hope this pattern comes to you handy. Check out the links below for more details. See you next time.